What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. We got another reaction today. This is going to be the Jonas Brothers, What a Man Gotta Do. This is going to be my first time checking out the Jonas Brothers on my channel, and I haven't really heard much music from them. I know back in their Disney days, I heard that song Year 3000. I still think that song is good. So there's obviously a big lapse in music that I've heard from them, so I'm definitely excited to check this out. This is a new music video, and I'm stoked. Let's do it. Okay. What? Why don't I remember that? I believe this is Nick Jonas. I didn't remember that he had such high vocals. Jesus. I'm not trying to be your part-time lover. Sign me up for that full-time, I'm yours. Doing his best impression of Tom Cruise here. So what a man gotta do? What a man gotta do? To be totally locked up by you. So that note that he hit just now, that's kind of what I remember when I think of the Jonas Brothers. There's almost like a rock edge to a very bright pop-sounding track. And as you guys know, I'm not typically too big into the... I guess, like, I won't want to call this bubblegum. I don't think that's what it is, but it just feels like safe pop sometimes, without much edge. But I think where Jonas Brothers have always kind of fixed that, at least from what I remember, is that little bit of edginess in the vocals. I do like that a lot when they hit those notes right there. Ain't trying to be wasting time on stupid people in cheap plans, I'm sure. I'm sure. So I have a question about the other dude. I saw like a live performance on New Year's, I think, of them, and I don't know if it's Kevin who plays the guitar. Does he sing at all in this group, or is he strictly like a guitar player? You guys gotta let me know in the comment section. I'm sure. I guess he probably might sing in this, so then I'll find out. Oh shit. So I'm gonna go back a little bit. That's definitely my favorite part. I do feel like the verse vocally is really good. I just feel like it's kind of like, I don't know, kind of slow moving a little bit. But when everything kind of comes together right there going into the chorus, I feel like that's where, based on this song and the one previous song that I know from them, that's where I feel like they're really shining here. Hell yeah. I love those high notes from him, shit.
I saw someone in my comment section the other day that was like, what is the obsession, what is this guy's obsession with everybody's high notes? I mentioned this before, but there was a lot of bands I listened to growing up that sang in that higher range, and there was a lot of harmonizing. And so when you listen to that music the majority of your life, and then you get into something like pop music, and you hear those types of vocal styles happening pretty prominently, that's where I always tend to draw myself to. So if that's why I mention that a lot, that's why. So, I'm not gonna lie, I went into this without having very high expectations. I feel like everything I've known about the Jonas Brothers hasn't always been positive, the whole purity ring thing and stuff like that, and this was obviously a long time ago. But their track record, I've never really known a lot of awesome things about them. And so to watch a music video where maybe there were parts of the song that I didn't care for it so much, but what I could pick up from this is that I bet they have a pretty cool discography. The reason I said that is I know that Nick and... Who's the other? Joe? Nick and Joe had pretty big solo careers. I don't know much about Kevin. Nick's vocals I am immediately drawn to for the exact reason I explained in this video. Kevin, or Joe, God, there's so many of these fucking guys. Joe, with the little bit of raspiness in his vocals, that more rock edge sound. I'm very interested to hear other stuff that they've done, because in the chorus, I feel like everything really came together here. Getting to hear a little bit of harmonies, hearing them riff off of each other. It's kind of cool that Kevin just kind of plays guitar and harmonizes in the back. I like that, especially when I saw a live performance of them. He was just jamming. I don't know if he was really playing live or not, but I don't really think it matters. I think it's just cool that that is something that he's been a staple with in that career. But like I said, for not really knowing much about the Jonas Brothers, I don't think this is the worst way to start, because there's definitely a lot of redeeming qualities to this song. You guys gotta let me know in the comment section what else I should be checking out from the Jonas Brothers, or if you want to show me their solo careers, I would love to see that too. The only songs I know from Nick, the only songs I know from Nick are that Bacon song, which I felt like the vocals on that song were really incredible, but like the lyrical content was so stupid. Just, I mean, Bacon, really? And then the other song that I know from him is that Chains song, which I actually think was like really incredible. So please let me know in the comment section about their solo careers, what you want to see. Yeah, and I'll do my best to try to react to those for you. Thank you guys so much. Subscribe if you want. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.